صلى عليه was a benefit itself, was to stand before the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi remained right till he died, and he died in the state of sajda while he was bowing down, prostrating before the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So accepted Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi was by the masses that it is related that people read Salatul Janazah at his grave continuously for 20 days. People would come and offer their Salatul Janazah and they would go. Not only did the people cry when Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi left this world, even the jinn shed tears. It is related that voices could be heard, people could not be seen. It was the jinn saying, ذَهَبَ الْفِكْهُ فَلَا فِكْهَ لَكُمْ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَكُونُوا خَلَفًا مَاتَ نُعْمَانُ فَمِنْ هَذَا الَّذِي يُحْيِي اللَّيْلَ إِذَا مَا سَجَفًا. Islamic jurisprudence has come to an end. Fiqh has come to an end. You have no jurist left. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and become kun khalaf. Nu'man has died. Who will now stay awake during the night before the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? People saw beautiful dreams after Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi died. Not one. Many people saw beautiful dreams. The likes of Abu Mu'az, the likes of Sadi ibn Sarha, the likes of Jad Tammar, the likes of Ja'far ibn Hussein, rahmatullah alayhim, saw a deep dream. Ibn Jawzi rahmatullah alayhi relates on the authority of Muhammad ibn Abu Raja'. But after Imam Muhammad, I saw Imam Muhammad rahmatullah alayhi in a dream and I asked, O Abu Abdullah, that was the kunniyat of Imam Muhammad. O Abu Abdullah, how did it go with the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He replied, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because I intended not to punish you. I asked, how is Imam Abu Yusuf rahmatullah alayhi? He replied, Imam Abu Yusuf rahmatullah alayhi is above me. I asked, how did it go with Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi? He replied, Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi is well beyond us. He is in the illiyin. This was Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi. An absolute master in every respect. And this was the respect that Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi had for Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi. That it is related, Imam Nabi relates in his work, Al-Minhaj, that on one occasion, Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi read his Salatul Fajr next to the Imam's grave. But he did not read Duaya Qanut, and at the same time, he didn't recite Bismillah aloud. Yet Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi was of the opinion that the Duaya Qanut should be read and Bismillah should be read aloud. But on that occasion, he did not read it. When asked as to why he left this out, and as to why he didn't read Bismillah aloud, he replied that out of respect for the Shaykh in this grave that I have left it on this occasion and I have not recited it. Such was the respect that Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak had, that tears would flow from his eyes and he would say, O Abu Hanifa, you have not let anyone that can take care of the work like yourself. This was the respect the ulama and the masters had for Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayh. And today look at our youngsters. They are ridiculing and they are mocking our Salafus Salihin, the great masters of the past. I conclude by saying, to speak ill about any Muslim, the consequence of such an evil is detrimental. نبي كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كإن العبد ليتكلم بالكلمة من رضوان الله لا يلقي لها بالا يرفع الله بها درجات وإن العبد ليتكلم بالكلمة من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالا يهوي بها في جهنم. Yet sometimes a person utters a word, he doesn't think much of what he has uttered, but such is the consequence of such a word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised his rank in Jannah. And sometimes a person utters a word, just one word from the displeasure of Allah, he doesn't think much about it, but such is the consequence of this one word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala him right in the fire of hell. The consequence of speaking ill about a Muslim is the consequence of such an evil is detrimental. Never mind speaking ill about the Salaf al-Salihin, about the great masters of the past, the Imam al-Mujtahideen, the Muhaddithin, the Mufassireen, and the Fuqaha. It is an attribute of a Muslim that he refrains from doing such a thing. As the consequence of such an evil is detrimental, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَكَدْ بَارَزَنِي بِالْحَرْبِ. Whoever keeps enmity, degrade, mock, speak ill, becomes an enemy of any friend of mine, of any wali, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I declare war with such a person. And you know what the outcome will be of such a person who declares war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَلِبُونَ. And on this I conclude, saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me the tawfiq to respect our elders and value what they did for the ummah and what they did for you and I. You and I are Muslims today because of our Salafus Salihin. They were the ones that conveyed the Quran to us. They were the ones that could convey the deen to us. They were the ones that conveyed the sunnah and the ahadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives me the tawfiq to act upon what I've said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the tawfiq to act upon what I've said. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.